प्री रीडिंग स्किल्स। और आज के प्रोग्राम के स्पीकर्स हैं डॉक्टर विजयराज बोलापल्ली सीआरसी दावणगिरी से, श्री राजू टी क्लिनिकल असिस्टेंट सीआरसी दावणगिरी से। और जो आज का हमारा सेशन शुरू होगा वो फर्स्ट स्पीकर से जब खत्म कर देंगे उसके बाद में आपको 5 मिनट मिलेंगे क्वेश्चन आंसर के लिए। आप क्वेश्चंस पूछ सकते हैं उस समय, उसके आपको आंसर्स दिए जाएंगे। तो सबसे पहले मैं इनवाइट कर रहा हूं डॉक्टर विजयराज बोलापल्ली सीआरसी दावणगिरी, वो अपना सेशंस स्टार्ट करेंगे। विजयराज
हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग, थैंक यू रंजीत जी, आई वेलकम टू पार्टिसिपेंट्स। हेलो, इज इट विजिबल, है प्रेजेंटेशन विजिबल है?
सर नाउ नाउ यू कैन प्रेजेंट यस सर।
या प्री रीडिंग स्किल्स आर द स्किल्स children need in order to help them to become a reader. Many of these skills are learned naturally during the course of a normal childhood at home and in the nursery or preschool environment. The impact of oral language on reading success. Taking skills and oral language development have on reading success. This means that when significant adults in a life pronounces words incorrectly, improper grammar, this is the kind of language that I will also use. See here, what we are discussing is any child or any person, when he was ready, getting ready to read, first the language has to develop. When you read, you are engaging more than a few brain functions such as phonemic awareness, visual and auditory process, comprehension, fluency, and more. The basis of the relationship between early spoken language and later reading development is thought to be casual in nature. And the language development is very casual. In the same way, the reading also will develop as per the language development, such that spoken language skills, especially phonological awareness and listening comprehension, are fundamental precursors to later successful reading. By talking and reading, the child will be doing a great deal to help these essential skills to develop a language. So any child, when we are considering a child, whether the child is a normal or with any type of disability, the child first has to develop the language. When the child has developed the initial language, then it will be easy for the child to make him to go for reading skills. So we are concentrating what are the language skills. Having conversations with your child about anything and everything is the best way to develop their language skills. So we keep on speaking with the children. Then only the children will be able to hear and they will be able to identify the words, and they are started repeating the words without knowing the meaning of the particular word. So reading stories to them will broaden their vocabulary. Make sure that your child gets plenty of opportunity to talk to other adults and children. So what are the language development? Here there are three major questions in language development. What is language? What is involved in language? What are the stages of language development? And the third question is language development driven by nurture or nature? We will see each question. So what is language? Language has no single definition, but Hockett's list of design features is a popular compromise. By this account, language has 9 attributes. First one is mode of communication. It's a vocal or auditory. Second one is semanticity, meaningfulness, pragmatic function, usefulness, interchangeability, ability to function as speaker and listener, cultural transmission, pass it down, arbitrariness, no necessary relationship between sign and signified, discreteness, made up of separable units, displacement, can refer to something in another place or time. And the last one is the productivity, can produce a theoretical number of meaningful utterances. These are the 9 attributes that makes a language. We are speaking in a particular language. It means it is a medium of a communication. When my idea wants to reach to you, I need to present that idea through a medium. And that medium is only a language. And this language is having a 9 attributes. Language learning involves. Second question, language learning involves. What does the language consist of? It consists of the phonological development. Second one, semantic development, syntactic development, pragmatic development, and metalinguistic. We know these, what are the, these, all these. Phonological development. Learn which sounds influence meaning. Sounds means phones. These special phones are called as phonemes and are the smallest meaningful sound changes in a language. Suppose, for example, if you say, take these are phonemes. We are able to recognize all phonemes. There are around 200 are there. And eventually our phonemic inventory narrows to match that of languages we are exposed to. 45 sounds of are there for English. Semantic development. Learn to manipulate minimal called morphemes. These are stems and affixes are 2 kinds of morphemes. Those are called prefix, suffix, fix. I think you have idea about these morphemes is a word. Syntactic development. Learn the impact that the ordering of meaningful elements has on meaning. This is called descriptive grammar. This is not what we learn in school, but rather how people actually speak. What we are taught in school is called a prescriptive grammar. So there are, in syntactic development, there are 2 grammar is there. One is the descriptive grammar and another one is the prescriptive grammar. Whereas the prescriptive grammar is the grammar that which taught in school. Whereas descriptive grammar that which we taught through learning the language in our home, at our home through our parents or through our neighbors by speaking. So descriptive grammar only describes the system of use. Prescriptive grammar imposes, means prescribes a particular system. So at home, we are speaking with the parents or any other people as a friendly, the grammar is not in a structured form. Whereas while we are studying or reading, the grammar will be in a structured form. So it is, it explains the syntactic development. So the syntactic development will also be developed at the stage of language development at the early. Pragmatic development. Learn the rules of use, including social rules. This is the rules where we have to use active voice, passive voice, all these things will come under this pragmatic development. Metalinguistic knowledge. This is linguistic knowledge about language. For instance, categorizing words, a noun, verb, etc. This may not actually be necessary for a language learning, but is a common feature. We say this, we have a beautiful day today. So we don't know. For this, it's not necessary to know the rule, but we will say automatically it will come and it will be a common. So what are the stages of primary language acquisition? There are, hello? Hello? Screen share outlet. Yes. Hello? Hello? There are? Hello?
Sir, you can carry on, sir.
Okay. There are 5 basic stages of language acquisition. First one is cooing. It appears about 6 months or so. All infants cooing, schools using all the phonemes from every language. Even congenitally deaf children also coos. You take any child, any deaf child. At about 6 months, the child will have some sort of sounds the child will make. That is cooing. This is the first stage of the language acquisition. Next one is babbling. It appears around 9 months. Infants are starting to selectively use the phonemes from their native language. Next one is one word utterances. It starts at around 12 months of the age. Children start using words. Telegraphic speech. Children start making multi-word utterances that lack function words. It's about 2 years old. Normal speech by about 5 to 6 years of age, children, we have almost normal speech. So from this, we will start the essential pre-reading skills will get started. So the language will be started from the 6 months age of the child. When the child was not able to develop these stages, then there will be a lack in a reading skills. So first we need to make the child to get acquainted with these stages of the development. Next, third question is, the language is nature or nurture? Skinner behaviorism. As per the Skinner, behaviorism could define the way we learn a language. Chomsky explains that human language learning appears to be innate in a way that violates behaviorist expectations. That is called as nativism. This explains that the language is language is not learnable, but it is automatically developed by the child or by any living organism. If we consider, why I mean to say is any living organism, because each and every living organism that it comes alive has a quality of expressing. That expressing is nothing but a language. The basis of relationship between early spoken language and later reading development is thought to be casual in nature, such that spoken language skills, especially phonological awareness and listening comprehension, are fundamental precursors to later successful reading. So children with limitations in phonological processing are at risk for early decoding problems, which can then lead to problems of reading comprehension. So we have, in the disability sector, we have so many children, those who are having a problem not understanding. Only comprehension problems will be there. Here, there are three are there. One is understanding, comprehension, and perception. So three words is having a three different meanings. So when any child with a disability, they have a limitations in phonological processing or risk. So they can't able to decode the words or letters, whatever the thing. So then there will be have a problem in reading. The evidence is compelling that a foundation in spoken language competence is important for the successful achievement of academic and social competence. Children with poor language skills are therefore at risk for reading and psychosocial problems. So when the child has developed language skills at the early stages of life, then the children will develop the reading skills automatically. But in this disability sector, we are finding the children, those who are having a poor language skills, is because of various reasons. So first we need to start develop the language skills, then we need to go for a reading skills. What about language? Could behaviorism not explain? So the behaviorism theory, we are speaking about the behaviorism theory for developing the reading skills. So to develop a reading skills, you need to develop the language skills first. So So these language skills will develop automatically by the behavior. That is, it means that in nature, the child will be, not only the child, every organism will be having a capability to express its needs. So how it will be express its need to survive. For this, they need some sort of language. If that develops, that makes the child or any organism to cope up with the higher stages of the development. So behaviorism, that which was not explained, is novel utterances. User can say anything he or she wants to communicate. Suppose if I want to communicate, I can say anything. Maybe a new, novel means new utterances. Should be a new for the other people, those who have to listen to them. Next one is the poverty of stimulus. A child may acquire a language even though the data itself is too poor to determine the language. The child needs no evidence for much of the knowledge it brings to the learning situation. So here the poverty of stimulus will explain that the child will acquire a language without knowing that what the situation, what it is and whatever. So to speak, suppose for example, mother says, bring that vessel. The child will go and bring that vessel and give it to her. But the child doesn't know whether the mother has told her in a proper way, structured way, or the meaning. The child will understand only that bring that vessel, that's all. She shows that points, that thing, and she will got it and it will give. This is the poverty of the stimulus. Speed of learning. Methods of learning which attempt to attain higher rates of learning without unacceptable reduction of comprehension or retention, and it is closely related to the speed reading. Suppose, for example, in school, we will see the children will start reading loudly and speedily. After reading, if you ask what is the meaning of that, the child can't be able to tell the meaning of it. Why? Because reading is going on, but the processing, what the child is reading, what the child was comprehending is based on that particular word, depends upon the perception. Then only the child may express what to read. Suppose, for example, here I will read this line. Suppose if I say the word creolization. Creolization, mixture of different cultures and language. Here, the language speaking in India, it will be different from the south region, north region, and east region. Why? Because the native language, different cultures will mix and it will create the problem. Creates a hybrid language. So this will initiate the child to mix different cultures and different language. This will also create a problem in the reading skill. Next one is conlanging. Conlanging is the language creation. There are so many new languages are created. So this new language they are creating is based on, depending on their perception and understanding of the decoding of the words or decoding of the letter. Further evidence for nativism. There are neurological evidence for dedicated processing, inability of other species, create linguistic utterances, even when exposed to language, critical periods for language development, preferential perception for speech sounds, pay more attention to the differences between speech and non-speech sounds, costly physiological adaptation, larynx and speech. These are the evidence of nativism. So, here both nature and nurture play valuable roles in language learning. For proper language development, you need a human brain and a human environment. There is a fundamental and reciprocal relationship among oral language, listening and speaking, written language and reading. So, for any child, or when the child is normal, the child is able to be first, you need to whether there has the language skills are available in that particular child or not. Suppose each and every child will be having, in spite of disability, each and every child is having a capability of some sort of skills to express their needs. It is nothing but a language. Basing on this language skills, we need to improve the, I have already told that in the previous, this language, phonological development and semantic development. These two development first we need to develop in that time. Therefore, semantic development develops, then the child is getting ready for the reading skills. Then we need to go for essential pre-reading skills for the child to develop a reading. Reading makes the child says that there is a lot of language development in there. Reading makes the child to these 5 points. One is novel utterances, one is poverty of stimulation, speed of learning, realization, and tone language. This initiates the child after developing the basic levels of the language skills, then the child was initiated to the reading skills. So we need to prepare the child to read a sentence or a paragraph. And that what the child was reading, the child has to get understand. So there is a fundamental relationship between the reading and the language development. Okay. Initially, reading and writing are dependent on oral language skills. Eventually, reading and writing extend the language. Young children with oral language skills learn to read. It must master and skills like decoding to fully understand what they are reading. There are ways to help struggling readers build these skills at home and at schools. That is the main theme of the conducting webinar on essential pre-reading skills. Why? Because, see, we have I said previously, three words are there with the same meaning, but they have three different meanings. One is understanding, comprehension, and perception. Understanding is different. Why? Because, suppose, for example, if I'm reading these slides, you are understanding somewhat of points, but your comprehension, without my reading also, you only read the slides, then also you can get comprehend. But the perception is will be the different. My perception is different, your perception is different. So we need to balance these three. Suppose, for example, if I'm reading a sentence, young children use oral language skills to learn how to read. We understood that the child has to develop language skills to read. In this, we need to get a comprehension that a reading skill, to develop a reading skill, first the child has to develop the language skills. That is the comprehension. Perception is what the child is reading.
Hello.
Hello. Sir. Hello, Randeep. My session is finished.
Hello.
Hello.
Sir, one participant question, sir.
Yes, sir.
3 year baby Down syndrome. How to interest in reading skills?
Yeah, first check the how Hello. The child Hello.
Yes,
sir.
Sir, tell me.
What is the question?
Sir, you can speak, sir.
Hello. Second person. The video are you?
Hello.
Second person. Sir, second, second question. What is the difference between stuttering and stammering?
Stuttering and stammering.
Yes.
Stuttering repetition sounds of word. Stuttering means the child, what he wants to speak is not coordinating between his motor development for the utterance of the word and his ear. Whereas stammering is not having an idea of that particular sound to produce. This is the difference.
Third question. Which one word utterance used by the infant?
Which
one word?
Which one word?
First, you use the word start. Starts with the vowel sound only. First word will start with vowel sounds only. Hello.
Hello.
Thank you, sir.
Next session, Raju sir.
Hello, good morning everyone.
దేనికి అదే సందీప
హలో
సార్ యూ కెన్ స్టార్ట్ యువర్ ప్రెజెంటేషన్
ఓకే థ్యాంక్ యూ
స్టార్ట్ చేయడానికి వచ్చింది సార్ నేనే చేస్తాను
హలో
సార్ యూ కెన్ స్టార్ట్ యువర్ ప్రెజెంటేషన్
యా ఐమ్ స్టార్టింగ్ షేరింగ్ వస్తుందా సార్
స్టార్ట్ షేరింగ్ కొట్టారా ఓపెన్ చేయండి సార్ పీపీటీ
ఓపెన్ అయింది పీపీటీ వస్తుందా సార్
వస్తుంది
ఓకే థ్యాంక్ యూ గుడ్ మార్నింగ్
ఫుల్ స్క్రీన్ చేయండి సార్
నౌ వీఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు సీ వాట్ ఆర్ ద ఎసెన్షియల్ రీడింగ్ స్కిల్స్ ఐ థింక్ మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద టీచర్స్ అండ్ స్పెషల్ ఎడ్యుకేటర్స్ ఆర్ వెయిటింగ్ ఫర్ దిస్ టాపిక్ how to develop pre-reading skills. Now we have seen that pre-reading skill are the first skills which we need to teach before entering into the reading skills. For example, why pre-reading skill is important? We do warm exercise every day to prepare our bodies for a sport or doing any other physical activity. Similarly, children need to warm up to prepare their minds for reading so that they can perform their best get the most out of it and increase their comprehension. So pre-reading skills are very important for reading. That is the reason these skills are called a game changer. Many children with developmental disabilities has difficulties in pre-reading skills. Why? Because they are developmentally delayed. They may have motor deficits. They may have motor. They may have speech and language. They may have cognitive deficits. They may have social and emotional difficulties. And they may also have other health hazards like epilepsy. So all these deficits makes learning much difficulties. All these skills are very important for any child to get ready for the school. So school readiness is a now challenge for the children with special needs. So that is the reason it is most important to prepare the children in pre-reading skills. So what are the essential pre-reading skills? Now this is the topic of today. There are seven essential pre-reading skills. Number one, matching. Number two, rhyming. Number three, letter skills. Number four, direction. Number five, motor skills. Number six, concept of print. Number seven, language skills. All the seven skills we are going to see. Somebody has raised the question in between during the first session that how to teach these pre-reading skills. As 3 years Down syndrome. How to teach the pre-reading skills? How should we make the child ready for reading? Now we are going to see those who are having doubts in this area. Please observe carefully. Please listen carefully that these seven skills are very important for any child. Okay. Number one, matching. So now I'm going to speak about matching. What is matching? See, we do everything. Reading is nothing but a matching activity. How can we say it is a matching activity? Suppose, example, what I'm giving is an apple. We see that apple. Then the child come to the school. The experience of apple is there in his mind. Then come to the school, he will learn A. So A is the sound, but it is a letter. So it denotes apple. A for apple, the teacher teaches him. So that is nothing but the matching. So all has an apple in his mind. So the letter A and the mind mapping. So both are matching. Then from A to apple. So that is also matching. So everywhere, whatever we teach, the reading skill is nothing but a matching activity. So the children learn to match the shapes, patterns, letters, and finally words. We surprise many times that all the preschools or early childhood education classes will have so many colorful items, which are having the matching, naming, identification, different shapes, sizes, patterns, words. Why all these activities? Because to teach the skill of matching. So matching is the number one, a first skill to teach pre-reading skills. Now I'm going to show some of the activities to improve. How to improve this pre-reading skill of matching? Number one, you see, what are the available at our home? See, the cards. The cards are very playing cards. Cards have different colors, different shapes, patterns, numbers also there. So all these things we can teach them to learn matching skills. Because you see, the card, black card will have some symbol, red cards have some other symbol. Symbols, numbers, colors, directions, all these the children has to learn at this age. Mostly they are 2.5 to 5 years of your children can do this activity. That's the reason you naturally, those age group children are interested in matching activities. They want to match they want to sort out objects. They want to know about the object. They want to get knowledge about the objects. So all the physical features, you can see all the physical features they will identify first, then go into the in detail. So start from the physical features, then go into the other features of the items. This is the matching. So number two, other activity you can see, you can give the activity books. So nowadays activity books are available in the market, which are having different colors, different shapes, different pictures. So even the pictures also given in the category wise, suppose the fruits, vegetables, animals, again the wild animal, domestic animals. So all these activities, different pictures are there in the activities. So you can give the child activity books to learn the skill of matching. Then the pairing clothes. So pairing cloth is one of the good activity what we can do at home. So most of the now children cannot go out because of the lockdown time. So whatever things are available at home, the clothes, the cars, available, that's not available, don't worry, you can use whatever the available things are at home. The same way, you can use the spoons, you can use the plates, you can use the saucers, you can use the cups, you can use the glasses. Everything is a matching. So matching is the first step that children will learn to develop pre-reading skills. Then shape sorters. I think most of the preschools will have all these shape sorters. Shapes have different sizes. The shape is there, then the size is there, the color is there, the pattern is there. So shape sorters are one of the good activity to develop matching skills. Next, the puzzles, jigsaw puzzles. And the schools, preschools, these activities are available, items are available. See, you can see the lion with a jigsaw puzzle. So one activity here, child has to see, identify, and match. That means he insert the puzzles each other. So he will learn the matching skills. Also, he will learn the identification of alphabets. So you can give something like activities, many activities, whatever is available at home. So these are the few activities, 5-6 activities I have shown you to improve the matching skills. Matching skills are very important to do any activity or to go for further. Number two is the rhyming. Rhyming is the second pre-reading skills. What is rhyming? What is rhyming? Rhyming is nothing but a phonemic awareness skill. See, why the teachers are rhyming skills? Because children should aware how the words are sound. That means the phonetic awareness. So the teachers indirectly teaching the phonics. So I have given a Machari Jal Ki Rani Hai. There is a rhyme in the preschool, Hindi. So it is a rhyme. It is going a rhyme. Machli jal ki rani hai, jeevan uska pani hai, haath lagao dar jayegi, bahar nikal mar jayegi. This is a rhyme. So rhymes are one of the best way to develop pre-reading skills. So like that, you can use different. The rhymes also, you can say, initially you can teach the full rhyme, number one. Number two, in between you can miss the end of the rhymes. Suppose Machli Jal Ki Rani Hai, Jeevan Uska Dash. So the child has to fill the blank. If the child has learned these skills, then you go to the little difficult skill. That is, when that gets too easy for them, make it harder. Dash Jal Ki Rani Hai, Machli. Machli the child has to fill. So in this way, the child will learn the words, even the vocabulary also the child will learn. Also, the child will learn. Then the child will have different ideas. They start rhyming. They start humming different kinds of rhymes. So it is nothing but understand that words are made of smaller sounds. Words are nothing but a combination of a smaller sound. This is what the children should know at this age. So second skill is the rhyming skills. We can do many activities. I'll show some of the activities. Encourage the children to sing along to nursery rhymes, pop songs, whatever they enjoy. So why it is enjoy? Because the age is like that. Children always, this preschool age children, like to enjoy, they like to play. So in a playway mode, enjoyment mode, you can teach them many things. And rhymes is one of the way to teach the pre-reading skills. Nursery rhymes. So that's the reason we see so many, all the preschools have rhymes. Now, rhymes are available in the market, in the online also. You can play near them. So children are naturally, will learn. If not learn, suppose in case of children with special needs, definitely we have to teach them this rhyming skills. Okay, play rhyming games such as rhyming puzzles. You can see the picture, rhyming puzzles. What is a rhyming puzzle? Number one, suppose a hen is there. So what is the rhyming word for hen? What is the rhyming word for hen? Pen. Hen, pen. So this is the rhyming word. Bee, tree. Cat, cap. Cake, snake. So these are the words, rhyming words. So we can say many words like that. Cat, mat, bat, hat, lat, something like that. So all these words are rhyming words you can teach in the preschool age. Okay, then rhyming race. What is rhyming race? You can see in the picture, what is a rhyming race? So the children are running with the pictures, two pictures. That means the other side, other two children are there who are having the same similar rhyming words. Suppose this child is having the cat in the hand, other child also have something mat in the hand, mat picture in the hand. So the boy has to run and touch the child who is having the picture card of mat. So whoever going and running and touching the child first, they are the winners. This is the rhyming race. So rhyming race also is one of the best activities, because these preschool children like to run, like to jump, like to do many gross motor activities. So let us encourage to conduct games like this. Next, hopscotch. This is the hopping inside the circle when say the rhyming word. Suppose there are circles. Always you conduct the game in a group situation. Now it is maybe not possible, but small groups, 2-3 children. So mark circles and the distance. Then when you say cat, rat. So cat, one child has to jump into the circle, then the rat, one child. So when the teacher says or the parent says the cat, then child has to jump into the circle. This is the hopscotch game. Then hiding objects. It may be the visual memory game, but hiding objects or hiding pictures in a particular place, also one of the activities you can do. That means you have to hide an object. Suppose a toy of a cat, a toy of a ball. You hide in some almirah, some place. Then ask the child to search for it. So the same way the dog. So rhyming, there should be rhyming words, there should be rhyming picture cards, rhyming even the objects also. So that way you can teach this rhyming skills. Then number three is the letter skills. Very important, recognizing letters, shapes, learning the most common sounds that each letter makes will give children a head start. That means children who learn letters, the shapes and sizes and the common sounds, then they have better chances to learn language skills fast. We know the language skills are listening, speaking, reading, and writing. So we are talking about the reading, that is the pre-reading skill we are talking about. But the children should have the essential the skills like listening and then speaking. So who that Dr. Vijayaraj was discussing about the importance of oral language and pre-reading skills. That's very right. So if the children learn language skills at the early age, they have the better chance to learn the reading skills also. So they'll have a head start always. So what are the activities to improve letter skills? So introduce the letters and their sounds gradually. So suppose in English we say A for apple, but we should teach them A for a, B for b, C for ka. These are the sounds. So the children should understand that every letter has a sound. So this is what we have to teach first. Then start with letters that are important to your child, such as initial, all those with an interesting shape which makes them easy to recognize. That means whatever the child is interested, suppose the child is interested in ball, teach ba sound first, then letter ba, b ba, the child will match automatically. So interesting is always important. Child's interest is very essential and very important to, in this, to teach the letter skills. Next, use letter sounds rather than names. So instead of apple, you say A for ant, A for ant. So all our books, activity books, and the preschool books, nursery books will have A for apple, B for bat, C for cat. So you can use that. Letter sounds are much more useful in learning to read. Generally, stick to lowercase letters to start with. So many of the I can say the parents or even the teachers sometimes make mistake here to start all the uppercase letters or capital letters. So don't go for that. Always starting letter should be capital. Other letters may be lowercase letters. So start like this. Then try using magnetic letters. I think we have, many of us have magnetic boards and magnetic letter. So you teach the letter skills. Let the child to you say that, suppose C, child has to pick up, then he has to stick onto the board. So this is the magnetic board. So magnetic letters are always used. If no magnetic letters, you can use a normal plain book, paper and pencil activity. Otherwise, you can use cards, alphabet cards. Okay. So this is the letter skills. Number four is the directional skills. Okay, what are the direction skills? So every print goes from left to right always. So direction, the children need to follow the direction left to right. Will not read from right to left, read from left to right. This skill a child needs to learn. This is a directional skills. You can see the picture. A boy is just a position of kicking ball to the kangaroo, kicking ball to the kangaroo. Okay, so this is a directional skill, starting from left to right. You can give worksheets like this, or you can practice directly also. So left and right. So directions are very important to learn pre-reading skills. Along not only the left and right, you can teach up and down. So inside, outside, front, back, all these skills. This is the correct right age to teach all these skills. So the where to start each line and which direction to go. Where to start, which direction to go. These two are very important. Starting and direction. So left to right. So whenever we teach the children, we put our finger just below the word or picture. We just move our finger, our index finger, from right to left to right. So that is what we. That is how we teach the directional skills. So sometimes children with developmental disabilities have this difficulty in pointing. So pointing also they should know. Pointing and starting from left to right, slowly moving the finger towards the left. So this skill they have to learn. So then later you can ask them where you should start. So initially you should demonstrate, then you ask the child to start. If the child has difficulty, again you teach the same. So repeat it many times. So try reading the words in reverse order also to demonstrate that the story does not make sense if you don't start in the right place. That means this is the skill to teach starting and direction. Where is the starting? Where is the ending? Okay. And the picture cards also we can use. Suppose we have the story pictures. Story pictures. A Thirsty Crow picture is there. Thirsty Crow. Pictures you can start from the left. The first starting picture in the beginning, left side. And let the child arrange other picture cards in the direction, right direction. Means on the second picture, third picture, in the direction. Means right way, left to right. This is how you can teach the directional skills. You can draw, you can use pictures, you can use even the real objects also you can use at home. So direction is the fourth skill we should teach to learn before reading skill. That means this is the one of the pre-reading skill. Then many activity books have activities which reinforce left-right direction, such as exercises for the child to draw. We usually teachers give worksheets or in the books like one dot in the left side, other dot in the right side. When you teach the even the pre-writing skills also, what we do, joining dots. One dot in the left side, other dot in the right side. The child has to join both the dots. So this is the starting and ending. Starting from the left dot and ending at the right dot. This is the skill, starting and ending. So this is how you can give many activities in the direction activity. Then fifth one is the motor skills, but it's very important. Motor skill is always, we suggest that we should teach the reading and writing skills together, because writing is an activity, important activity. So it is an expression activity. Reading means it is a comprehension. Child will understand what is there. Then writing is the expression. So practicing writing letters and words, and the children learn to read them, will help it all to sink in. So a good pencil grip and control is useful. That means the child, if the child wants to write, he should have the pencil grip. So here the fine motor skills are very important. The pincer grasp, then the tripod grasp, which is useful for the holding the pencil. So what are the activities to improve this motor skills, especially the fine motor skills? There are so many activities, the daily activities you can give to the child. Number one, encourage your child to be creative drawing. Drawing and paintings are natural skills, what the teachers teach in the school. But what do we teach at home? See, the bottle caps, screwing and unscrewing. Then the second picture is having, other picture is having, and the using the box, a shoe box, then making holes, then inserting the pencils in the holes. Very good fine motor activities. And you can use the toothpicks also. For example, we have a small masala boxes, which has all salt, pepper, salt, small containers, which has a small concept of print. So the concept of print is all about knowing how to handle books, holding them the right way, turning the pages in sequence, exploring the pictures, knowing that the words can be read to tell a story. So the concept of print has two aspects. Number one, print motivation. Number two, print awareness. What is print motivation? It is nothing but we are making the children excited and interested in the book. So there are some activities which are given to improve this print motivation skill. So make sure that books sharing time is fun. So whenever the child is happy, when the child is playing, enjoying, in the playful mode, and you give the activity and say that the activity whatever you are giving, it will make the child happy. Oh, this is the first thing. The second thing is for children with short attention span, children who may have short attention span, so such children we should give activity in a shorter manner. That means give the 5% of activity. Suppose there are 5 activities, give one activity at a time, then give break, then give another activity, then creep, then break. So that the 5 activities we should not give at the same time. So giving in the slots, but more often. So next, third point is don't get upset when the children put books in their mouth. Children usually keep the papers, sometimes books in the mouth. We should not allow that, but if they are doing so don't get upset. Let the children explore the book. The children explore the book, look at the pages. Okay, that is how the children will get interested. Then the fourth point is choose the books about things that interest the child. The child may be interested in story books, comics, just picture books. Whatever that they like, you please give them such books so that the children will enjoy it. Then read with a natural but cheerful voice. Read with a natural but cheerful voice. Whenever you are reading, the children should understand the clarity of your voice. The children should understand that, oh, this is a mother sound or father sound or teacher sound. They should be able to differentiate it, identify it, and read with a cheerful voice so that they can be interested in whatever you are reading. So they may ask the questions also, what are you reading then? So that is how we should develop the interest in print. Then next slide, module your voice and pitch when you read different content. We know that rhymes have different kinds of pitch, high pitch, low pitch, moderate pitch, or mild pitch. So use rhymes more often and stories which has high and low pitch and different kinds of voices. Then make sure that your facial body expressions suit what you are reading so that the children are interested in what you are reading. And let the child, the children to tell or narrate a story. That means give opportunity to tell or to narrate whatever they listen, whatever they understand. Then explain the meanings of new vocabulary and encourage the child to use so. So new vocabulary is always possible in the stories. Suppose that there is a small sentence, no problem. You identify the sentence, mark it, highlight it, and explain the meaning. So meanings, that is how we learn, the children learn the meanings of the words. And is one way to develop vocabulary also. The part B is print awareness. Number one is print motivation. Number two is print awareness. Print awareness means whatever the child is speaking, the spoken words are converted into the print. So the child should understand the relation. Whatever I'm speaking, those words only are coming on the paper, black and white. So knowing that how to follow the words on a page and knowing how to hold a book, all these are the skills. So number one is the words that are spoken are coming on the page or book. Number two, knowing how to follow words on a page. Number three, knowing how to hold a book. So these are the print awareness skill. So how to improve this skill? Allow the children to handle the book and turn pages. So this is the first picture I am showing. Then I ask the children to arrange their books in their bags, school bags, on the racks, and use your finger to point out words as you move across the page. When you are reading, we should point, in the earlier slide I told about the left and right orientation. Reading from left to right. The same skill you can teach here by pointing the finger. Next, point out signs in your environment. Whatever the signs, symbols, suppose the traffic lights, symbols. you can show them whatever available in the environment, suppose the hospital pictures, a bank, so you can show it. The read books with large bold print, so children are interested in large print always, big pictures, colorful pictures, so show them first. So that bold print is always attracting to the children. So they can motivated, they can use the words also. Then introduce the cover and talk about the author and illustration. So whenever we talk about stories, who is the author? What is the book name? We should explain that. Then last one is the seventh skill is language skills. The more experience children have of language, the more easily they will learn to read. That means language is always important for reading. So child needs to hear and join in conversation with adults and children and listen to stories and poetry of all sorts. That means the children has to converse with adults and children. So give opportunities to make conversation with adults and peer group and older children also. What are the activities we can give to improve the language skills? Having conversation with the child about anything and everything is the best way to develop their language skills. That means let the child talk, let the child converse, whatever the manner they convert, encourage them, give them a lot of opportunities so that they will express themselves. This is the one way. So giving the opportunities for conversation. Number two, reading stories to them. That means you read story for them so that they will improve, they increase the vocabulary. Number three, make sure that your child gets plenty of opportunity to talk to others, adults and children. Then number four, label the things. Whatever is there, there is a picture, you can see the tea, sugar, salt, coffee, and the box, containers, you can label them. So labeling is always important, and they will keep on looking at, keep on observing it, ultimately they will learn it. So next point, talk with children about what you are doing. So that means it has so much of vocabulary. When you are doing something, suppose the mother is cooking food, explain what is the curry you are making, what food you are preparing. So the child will interested in, they will observe. Suppose they observe in the cooking food, let them encourage, let them observe when you are doing. Not only the cooking activity, whatever the activity you are doing at home, parents, then encourage the child to observe what you are doing. And you can explain them what you are doing. That is how they'll develop the language skills. Then ask them what or why. So questions will have so many things. That means questioning ability shows the child has some comprehension. It shows the comprehension ability. So what you are doing, why you are doing, when you are doing, where is the mother, where is the father, all the questions. Questioning means the child is understanding what you are doing. The child is thinking. So encourage them to question. That is one of the best way to improve the language skills. So then be patient. Don't be hurry-burry. Don't expect the child to answer immediately. Let them explain in their own way. Let them take their own time. And we, just as a parent, be patient. So tell stories. Encourage play, pretend play. Then read stories with beginning, middle and end. That means child should understand that there is a starting point, there is a middle point, there is an ending point. So this skill we can teach through stories. You can teach through picture cards. As I told you earlier, the picture cards, 1, 2, 3. Now picture cards, picture charts, story charts also are available in the market. Every picture, there is a number 1, 2, 3. Their children will learn starting to ending. The children also will learn what is the sequence of the story. So that is how you can teach the starting, beginning, middle, and the end. And let them help you to tell. Flame boards are available in most of the schools, will have flame boards. So let the child arrange the pictures, stick the flame boards to stories on the board. So this is how you can develop the language skills. So all these are seven essential pre-reading skills. You can see the essential pre-reading skills: matching, rhyming, letter skills, direction, motor skills, concept of print, language skills. All these are very important before the child start reading. So all the preschool teachers, I can practice this. Parents, you can practice this. Okay. So any doubts? So thank you so much.